Hey YouTube, what's up? This is Ben from the beaphotographer channel, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at how the Luma and RGB channels on the curves tool in Capture One Pro 20 are different, and how having Luma is such a nice option, which will give you a lot more control over your images. Now don't worry, the next video will not be about curves. We're going to move into layers and layer masks in Capture One Pro 20, but this is kind of the be-all end-all of understanding curves as much as you can within Capture One Pro. So let's start with this image here. This is a sunrise image that I took in Santa Barbara at Campus Point, and you can see that we have no curves adjustments here. This is straight out of the camera, and this is exactly what it comes out as. Now, if we were to just take the midpoints and, for exaggeration an example, drag them down, you can see that it's adding a lot of orange. It's giving us a much higher contrast in the image, and it is affecting the colors as well as the tones, right? So we're changing the brightness and darkness values, but it's also changing the color. Now, if we reset this and went to the Luma channel in the curves and went down, you can see it's not adding any more orange, and as we go brighter, it's not really reducing it. It is purely controlling tones here, and this is really nice because for especially landscape or images with skin tones, you have absolute control without changing the appearance of the colors in the image. So again, here it is on the Luma channel, and then if we did this with the RGB channel, and we did it just about that same amount, you can see that there's way more orange being added to the image. And yes, that's nice, but sometimes you don't want those colors, because imagine if that's somebody's skin and you're trying to change the image that much using the curves, and it just adds a ton of orange to their skin and they're not actually that tan. For instance, if we take this really old picture of me and we change the Luma, and let's say we add an S curve, so we're just gonna add the brightness up here and we're gonna change the midtones a little bit. Let's say we have that as our Luma curve, right? If we created a new variant of this image and we reset it and we did the same thing using RGB, check out what happens to my skin. So we're gonna bring this down, gonna bring that up, and then we're gonna bring up the brightness here. And you can see all of a sudden, if we zoom in on both the images, yes, they're blurry, but this is a tones image. You can see all of a sudden my skin in the one that has the RGB controls changed to it, my skin looks way more red and orange, right? And I actually don't look this red in the face in real life. I'm not this tan. And we were able to add that contrast with just the Luma on this image by controlling it here, right? So if I wanted the shadows to be darker, I could make those shadows darker, but it's not adding redness to my face. Or I could bring the brights up, and you can see that as we change with Luma, it is not changing the color tones. If we changed it here on the RGB values, right, you can see that as I make them brighter, that red and orange in my skin is coming up. To make it darker, my skin looks more dull. So Luma gives you control of all the channels without changing the color. So think about it as pure tone control without color, and that is a really nice tool to have. And then if you wanted, of course, you can go in the different channels and add the color in or out yourself. And you know how to do that because you watched the previous two videos on curves. Let me know what your video tutorial requests are. I'm happy to make them. I hope you subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Peace.